Good morning, children. So today we are in a math class. So we are going to lesson number 9, numbers from 11 to 20. So you initially you learn numbers from 1 to 9, and then you learn the number 10. Then you learned units and tens. Now we go on one step further, that is numbers from 11 to 20. Let's learn how to write numbers from 11 to 20. So after 10 is 11. So 1 to 10, once you all finish writing, go to the number 11. So this is your tens unit and this is your, tens column, this is units column, right? So your 11 is 1 10 and 1 unit, correct? That's what we learned in the previous chapter. So 11 is 1 10, 1 unit, 11. 12 is 1 10 and 2 units, 12. 13, 1 10 and 3 units, 13. Next number after 13 is 14, 1 10 and 4 units, 14. The next number is 15, 1 10 and 5 units. Next children, what comes the next number? Is 1 10 and 6 units, 16. So next is 1 10 and 7 units, 17. So number after 17 is 18. Very good. 1 10 and 8 units, 18. The number after 18 is 1 10 and 9 units, 19. Now what happens? Now we go to the next number, that's 2 tens and 0 units, that's 20. Okay, so number after 19 is 20. That is a group of tens, two sets of tens. Two group of tens is 2 tens and 0 units, 20. So 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20. So in this chapter we'll be learning from 11 to 20. So what all comes, what you can learn between 11 and 20, there are 10 numbers. So we'll be learning what comes after, what comes before and what comes between the numbers from 11 to 20. Okay? And we'll also go back to the units and tens. So what forms, how many groups of tens we have and how many units of the object we will draw and write. So that's this chapter is all about. So in your classwork book, write chapter lesson number 9, numbers 11 to 20, write the date and write tens and units column and write from 11 to 20. The next I'll take you all to what comes after. So in it, you all have learnt in the chapter number 9. So what does the chapter number 9 you all learnt? Numbers that comes before, after and in between from 1 to 9. Now going further from number 11 to 20, we'll be learning what comes after. So I have the first question is, here is 10. So I've written the number 10. So what comes after 10? So you'll have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So the number after 10 is 11. Okay, so 11 comes after 10. So 10 is before 11, right? Any number that comes after a number is bigger. The number comes before is it's smaller. Okay, so 11 is bigger than 10. 11 is big than 10. So 10 and 11. 11 comes after 10. The next question is 13. What comes after 13? So count from 11, 12, 13, 14. So number after 13 is 14. I want you all to copy this in your classwork book. Then the third question, 16. What comes after 16? 16. So we'll go from 11, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So the number after 16 is 17. That is 1, 10 and 7 units, 17. Okay children, so this one I want you all to see. This is number 19. So what comes after 19? After 19 comes 2 tens and 0 units 20. Okay? So count from 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19 and 20. Okay? So 2 tens and 0 units 20. So this is what comes after. I'll take you all to the next main. What comes before? So what happens here? The number is given and you have to write the number that comes before that particular number. So here we have 12. What comes before 12? Is just one number smaller than this digit. Okay? So 12, what is before 12? 10, 11, 12. So what comes before 12 is 11. Basically, you'll have to count backwards. If we count 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Like that, 20, 19, 18, 17, 16, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11. Okay, so number which comes before, you have to count backwards. The second one is number 18. So what comes before 18? 20, 19, 18, 17. So number that comes before 18 is 17. So it is 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. The number which comes before 18 is 17. What is a number that comes before 15? Again, you want to go from count backwards from 20. 20, 19, 18, 14, 17, 15, 16, 15 and 14. So 14 comes before 15. 1, 10 and 4 units, 14. The next sum is dash 20. So what comes before 20? Before 20 will be 20, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So what was the number before 20? 19. So 19 is a number that comes before 20. Understood, children? So when you have to get the number before 12, it will be... It's in a number from 11 to 20, so let's count from 11 to 20 itself. So 11, 12. So what was before 12? 11. So that's 11. Now there's 18. What comes before 18? 11. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So 18. You got 18 on your fingers. So what is the number which you counted before 18? 17. So that is 17. So there's 15 here. What comes before 15? 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. The number before 15 is 14. That's your 14. This you can do even on your number line. Write the number from 11 to 20. Go backwards or frontwards. It's fine. Whichever number you get, the number before that, you have to fill in. Okay? So this is 9-20. What comes before 20? 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So what's the number before 20? 19. That's your 19. So this is what comes after and what comes before. Next we'll go to what comes in between. So here you have four sums. The first one, 10-12. So what is a number that comes between 10 and 12? We'll make it a box so you'll understand much better. So children, tell me what comes between 10 and 12. So you should start counting from number 10. You should count from 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So what comes between 10 and 12? 11. That's basically what comes after 10 and what comes before 12. That's your 11. Okay, so next sum, 13-15. So what comes in between 13 and 15? That's after 13 and before 15. So 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So what comes after between 13 and 15? 11, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So between 13 and 15 is your 14. So 14. So 18-20. What comes between 18 and 20? 11, again 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So between your 18 and 20 you have 19. So 18, 19 and 20. So that's 14-18. So 16-18. So 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Okay, so 16, 17, 18. So what was between 16 and 18? 17. 1, 10 and 7 units, 17. So this is what comes in between. I want you children to copy this in your classwork and then go to your textbook, page number 110. There's a bagpiper who's blowing his pipe and then the rats behind him. So there are numbers on the rats. Now what you have to do, there are certain numbers, the certain rats are the numbers and some rats it's blank. You need to fill the numbers. So write the missing numbers. So you have to see 11-13-15. So fill in the numbers 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Okay, then you go to page number 111. Here it again says write the number which comes after. So I taught you all how to write the number which comes after. So there's 17, 18, 19. So dash, what comes after 19? 20. So you'll have to write 20. In the next, there leaf and 11, 12, dash. So what you have to write? 11, 12, 13. Very good, right? 13 there. The next question are the mangoes. 15, 16, 17. So you have to write 17 and go to the next. Write the numbers that comes before dash 18, 19. So go backwards 19, 18, 17. Then there's dash 13, 14, 14, 13, 12. Then down the mangoes a dash 15, 16, 16, 15, 14. Okay, 14 is your answer. What comes in between? Again on the houses. 16-18. So 16-18. So that is your 17. 13-15. 13-15. 14. 17-19. So 17-19. 17-18-19. Okay. So that's your answer. Please write it down in your textbook. Then we'll go to the color the leaf with bigger number in each pair. So as I told you all, the number which comes first is small and the number which comes next is bigger than the previous number. It's big by 1, right? So between 15 and 16, which is a big number? Which comes first, 15 or 16? 15 comes first, then comes 16, right? So 16 is the big number. So you have to color only the leaf which has the big number. So you have to color the leaf with 16 in it. Then go to the next one, 17 and 18. So 17 and 18, between 17 and 18, which is big? Which number comes first? 17 comes first or 18 comes first? 17, 18. So 17 comes first, right children? So 18 is the big number. So you have to color the leaf which has big number, that's 18. Only the number 18, not the 17 leaf. Then there's 10 and 11. So again, which number comes first, 10 or 11? 10 comes first, so the number 11 is the bigger number. So you have to color the number 11. After that you have 13 and 10. So which number do you want to color? Do you have to color 13 or 10? Which number comes first, 13 or 10? 10 comes first, then you have 13. So 10, 11, 12, 13. So 13 is quite bigger than 10, right? It's big. So 13 is the big number. Color the number 13, which is because that's bigger than 10. Now let's go to the next session. Color the leaf with smaller number in each pair. So which number is small, 11 or 12? The number which comes first is small, right? So color the number 11, the leaf 11, because 11 is smaller than 12. Then 18 and 19, 18 comes first, 19 comes later. So 18 is the smaller number, 19 is the big one, right? Bigger one. So let's color the smaller number 18. Next is 13 and 10. So what do we do? Which is the bigger number, 13 or 10? 13 is big, 10 is small, because 10 comes first, then comes 11, 12, and then comes 13. So you have to color the leaf 10. 10 is the smaller number. Go to the next session, 15 and 11. So which number is big, your children, and which is small? That comes first is small, the number which comes later is big, right? So that's a thumb rule. What is the thumb rule? The number which comes first in the number line is small, and the number which comes after is big. So 11 comes before 15. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 comes later. So 11 is a smaller number. So let's share the leaf which has smaller number 11. Next page, 115. Count the objects, compare the number of objects and the number given against the group. Put tick if they are same and put X mark if they are not same. So this is again, this takes us to the previous chapter, tens and units. How I had taught you all a bunch of straws, which is 10 is one group, and then you have the units. So this is the same thing. Now I have the same thing for you all. Now I have the straw. Let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So this is a group of 10, 1, 10. So similarly, there's 1, 10, one bunch of chalk in this image. So that's 1, 10. And what are the loose chalks which are there? There are about 5 chalks. So I'll take 5 straws. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So this is 1, 10 and 5 units, right? So this is 15. 1, 10 and 5 units is equal to 15. So they've given the number 15. If 15 is correct, you have to tick. So that is already done for you all. So let's go to the next one. This bunch of grapes, let's count how many grapes are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 grapes in this bunch. Can you all see, children? 10 grapes in this bunch. And in the next bunch, there are only 2 grapes. So 10, 1 tens and 2 units gives you all 12. So how many? One group of 10 is 110 and there are 2 units. So this is 10, 11, 12. So that's 12 and there is 12 here. So let's put a tick mark. Now there are biscuits in the plate. So count the biscuits. How many are there in the first plate? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There are 10 cookies or biscuits. And in the next plate, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 1, 10 and 8 units gives you all 18. So 18 is correct. So let's put the tick mark there, okay? So let's go to the next page, number 116. What does it say? Group of tens and units by drawing. So we learned in a previous chapter about group of 10 is 110 and every single object which you count is one unit, correct? So the same thing here, they've given 12. Now 12 is 110 and 2 units. 12 is nothing but 110 and 2 units. So what you have to do? Draw 10 objects together in one box and 2 objects together in the other box. That will give you all 12. So they've given 15. So what basically you'll have to do? The next column here, there's 15 here. So what you have to do? You have to, how many tens will be in 15? 1, 10. And how many units? 5 units, correct? 1, 10 and 5 units is 15. So in draw the tens object and draw the units object. You can draw anything. Like here you have pencils, you can draw flowers, balls, leaf, lollipops, anything. Triangles, shapes, circles. Okay, so you have to draw 10 of the object and then plus how many should be your 5 units. So you have to draw 5 objects in units. So 10 plus 5 will be your 15. Okay, children, that's your homework. Please do that. Okay, I want you all to fill this and send the photo to me. So finish all the exercises in your textbook. Write this in your notebook, the numbers from 11 to 20. Then you'll have to write what comes after, before, in between. Meanwhile, when we go to this chapter, at the beginning of the chapter, you have the numbers from 11, 12. You'll have to write all this. Write the 11s, 12, 13, 14. Then there are numbers to trace also. 15, 16, 17, 18. You all have to fill up the whole thing. 18, 19, 20. Once you all finish this, from 11 to 20, I want you all to write all this. So 11 to 20, just the way they've given an example, trace it, then copy the same thing from 11 to 20. Once you all finish this, that's when you have to write the numbers in your notebook, 11 to 20. Then write what comes in before, after, and in between. Then do these exercises, okay, as I explained to you all. So that's it for today, children. Please do your homework and send it to me. Thank you. Have a good day.